Okay, we're in Kitsilano, just off Point Grey Road at Trafalgar, and we're going to bike back to Second Beach parking lot in Stanley Park. We're getting off Point Grey Road right here, right away onto Lower Point Grey Road. There's no traffic, and then we'll swoop down into Kitsilano Park and take it from there. No traffic, I just about got over there, but that's all right. So you can get off Point Grey Road at Trafalgar onto this Lower Point Grey Road, Point Grey. A lot less traffic along here. So we're doing part of what is called the Seaside bike trail in Kitsilano, and then into Vancouver itself. We have to go up and cross the Burrard Street Bridge and then down onto Seaside on the other side towards Stanley Park. Coming up off the Point Grey Road now and into Kitsilano Park past the pool. Pool's right down here. It is a saltwater pool, which is kind of cool. Says no bikes here, but I'm going to do a bike anyways. Just for a short stretch along here. Planning on doing a boardwalk, sea walk like this all the way along, extending Seaside from Kitsilano to Jericho Beach, which would be fantastic. Okay, now we're legal again. We're running all along beside Seaside Beach now on our left. And we have to dismount up here to pass by the Boathouse Restaurant. Look at Seaside, Kitsilano Beach here. Not that busy today because the sun's not out as much as it would normally be on a summer day. And also I find around 5 o'clock is a good time because people are going to eat. we can mount up again. Still Kits Beach here. Like, it gets a bit sandy up here though. Gotta watch it, you don't go flying. We're doing this instead of going along Cornwall. Up from Kitts Beach.
That'd be hard, the NES coming through.
And heading towards the Maritime Museum, where we'll have to go up. On to Broad Street Bridge. So now we're heading up towards Broad Street Bridge. We actually overshoot it by one block doing this. We're on Chestnut Street right now. They do a lot to avoid traffic. Here, it's a great bike ride around False Creek. And you can go all the way around False Creek and along the east side and back to Stanley Park that way as well. That's the way we're going. It's a lovely bike ride, we'll do that one day. Cypress Avenue is the one that leads you to Broad Street Bridge. Have your light on there, buddy. So the sooner we're off this shit, the better. But sometimes we gotta do it. Street Bridge. Better, you didn't have to do that crossover there. If they'd made one sidewalk, say this one, just pedestrian. The other one's much wider on the other side. Made that two-lane bike sidewalk. Put a fence along the edge of it. Protect bikers from heading off into traffic. It's quite a high curb. Then they could have kept all the lanes on the bridge for cars. And it would have even as good, it's not better for bikers. Because it makes it very difficult for car drivers ahead to the left when they come along Pacific to turn right onto Burrard Street. The merge lane is gone now. You've got to jump not only bikers, but the first lane of traffic to get in. It's very difficult, dangerous. I'm sure there's accidents. Could have avoided all that and kept all the lanes on the bridge. I guess nobody thought of that. Down to beach or across the bridge. And I'll be getting onto a bike path the rest of the way to Stanley Park in a minute. Underneath the bridge now. There we go. Heading towards Stanley Park. Seem to have had the headwind both directions today. Oh, well, single lane there. So we're on the other side of Falls Creek off to our left. Looking across at where we were biking before. Okay. Come around the corner here. cruise ship heading out ahead of us there. From underneath Lionsgate Bridge. Up to the Georgia Street. Side Beach Avenue again here, but it is a bike path. So we're going to leave Beach behind now and head into Stanley Park. Thank you. you hang a right, you can go around Stanley Park the other way, but we're going this way. Well, around the park is only one way.
Definitely not.
Going by the other saltwater pool off to our left. Second beach, third beach. In Stanley Park. So now we're gonna have to do a bit of parking lot jumping to get to the car. Gotta watch traffic along here. Maybe another day we'll go right around. And here's the car. Right here. We are back. So Stanley Park parking is probably the most reasonable around still. It's $3 an hour, I think, up to $9, and that's $10 for the whole day till 11 o'clock at night. Isn't bad. So I hope you enjoyed that route. I'm not showing you the scenery as much as the route for now, until the technology gets better. So that's it for this bike ride.